Ciao, ciao. Alors, j'espère que vous avez apprécié cette émission. Revenez-nous la semaine prochaine. Ici Normand Sauvé. Bonne semaine.
Welcome to Radio Video. Today we have Nina Hagen with us. Hi, Nina. How are you today?
Okay,
she's okay. Nina, first thing I want to ask you is, if you had been born a man, do you think you would have done the same thing with your life that you are doing now? Do you think it would have made a big difference to you, or if you would have done, you know, something else?
I think I would be in the position of David Bowie by then. I mean, by now.
The same kind of...
The same position.
Really, you would definitely have been music. You would have been into music the same way. Yeah?
Yeah, into music and acting, movies and...
Voice and bell. Also, I would like to know about your musical influences. Who, you know, in the business do you admire? And are there any other female rock people that you think are good?
Yeah, when I was like 12 years old, I was into Janis Joplin and James Brown, the Beatles, and Brian Ferry and all that, and the Stones. And I sang them songs.
Yeah.
And I still do today. And I love Patti Smith, Davy Jones, Bowie, and Ariana from the Smiths, who is one of the wildest. She just got two black babies called Pablo and Pedro, twins.
Yes,
she's very fruitful.
I wanted to ask you also about your daughter and if you ever take her on the road with you.
She's on the road with us. She's a gypsy like we all are, and we have our own babysitter, Sergeant Kay, and she is responsible for Cosma's free time when she is off time.
Yeah. Is it hard to have her on the road with you?
No, fun? Not at all. It's fun. It's fun to be on the road, and we travel kind of every day. We get up at 9 or at 10 and we go to the airport and get to the next city, or we make a car ride when it's not too far. And we go in the hotel and we pack the toys out, or we do whatever we do, and then I go to the sound check, I give her to Kay, and they have a great time because she and Kay, they know each other for a long time. I planned it like that. Then I go on tour to have a nanny all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody that she knows really well.
Yeah. Somebody who's really good for that job. And
Sergeant
Kay. Oh, yeah. I trust Sergeant Kay. I'm not pretending.
For a while I was in London, in this dirty town, in a very dirty hotel, and I met this kid, and he was pulled up his feet, and alcohol was really drunk, and somehow, yeah. And we going in the lift, and I'm driving upstairs where his girlfriend Nancy was in a room. Open the door, and the door was closed from the inside for Nancy, and Nancy didn't wake up, and just thought Nancy is dead.
God, and you were just saying before about how you saw a UFO when you were pregnant, and I would like to know if you can describe it to me at all and these people.
Okay, I was pregnant in the fourth month. I was sleeping in my bed already, and I woke up and I walked to the curtain. I pushed the curtain away, and I saw it floating right over my head. It was like a balcony, and there was much space, and it was a beach house close to the beach. It was dark outside, and I saw the huge thing with all of the best colors, like super super pink, super turquoise, blue, green, yellow, mellow, and white. And they changed colors, and it was a totally different energy. And I was standing with an open mouth, like paralyzed, but very nicely. I didn't move. I couldn't talk. I didn't call anybody. I was just standing there with full fit from with their energy.
Yeah.
And then they took the colors away, and it became kind of meat color. And I could look through. I could look inside. And there were beings going around and making things on little computers, and they were working in there. It was like an office. And I thought by myself, by my little human mind, I thought, oh, they're taking my dates now. I must be very important, and my baby too. And the energy is indescribable. I mean, I hope they come again and take me on board to show me some more.
You talk about God in any of your songs? Is any of it like a metaphor for the way you believe?
Yes, sure. Many songs I try to explain myself. I pray in the songs. Sure.
Because you write the lyrics to your songs, right?
Yeah, not only me. Sometimes I also sing lyrics from other people, but I mostly sing my own lyrics.
And you've just done a video of the song Smack Jack.
Yes, this was my last video, and Juliana did it also.